seized. If you guys enjoyed the intro or enjoy what you see here, go follow SM_battle_stories on Instagram or get some work done yourself. What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, we're going to be going through my Hell in a Cell 2018 predictions. I am recording these predictions prior to the go-home shows of Monday Night Raw and SmackDown Live, so there may be one or two matches that I don't have in this prediction video. As of recording right now, there are only 7 matches on the card confirmed. I have an idea on what some other matches will be, and I'll run through those right quick. The first one is Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose versus Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler for the Raw Tag Team Championships. I feel like that match could be added before, you know, the pay-per-view on Sunday, and if that does happen, then I'm going to go with the Shield winning. And another match is possibly Kevin Owens versus Bobby Lashley, and I think that Bobby Lashley would probably end up getting the win for some stupid reason. So if those matches end up getting added, and there's my predictions for them, I'm just making a bold prediction. Those matches may not even be on the card, but that's just something I'm throwing out there. But this match, or this pay-per-view, I might add, is, I don't know, I don't like the name of a pay-per-view being named after a match stipulation like TLC, Money in the Bank. I just don't like that. I wish that they'd get more creative. You know, Vengeance, No Mercy, Unforgiven, Judgment Day, stuff like that I liked a lot more. But let's go ahead and get into the card. We got 7 matches to run through, so let's go ahead and hit it. So starting things off, guys, we do have the mixed tag team match between Daniel Bryan and Brie Bella taking on The Miz and Maurice. And there's a couple ways this thing needs to go. First of all, you know, they do have a match later on at the Super Showdown or whatever in Australia. The winner of that will get an automatic WWE Championship match. So I could see Daniel Bryan and Brie Bella winning here, and then The Miz winning at the Super Showdown. Or The Miz could win both. Either way, it really doesn't matter, but The Miz definitely needs to win that WWE Championship opportunity at the Super Showdown. He needs to defeat by cheating. It doesn't matter. He just needs to beat the Daniel Bryan by cheating or shenanigans or whatever it is, and then we need to have The Miz go on to defeat AJ Styles finally for the WWE Championship. Therefore, Daniel Bryan can win the Royal Rumble, and we will have our main event for WrestleMania, Daniel Bryan versus The Miz, WWE Championship, where the Daniel Bryan will then conquer all the odds, all the shenanigans, all the obstacles, and capture the WWE Championship. So, just for the sake of that Australian pay-per-view or whatever it is, I'm going to pick Daniel Bryan and Brie Bella to pick up the victory right here. Next up, we have an odd Hell in a Cell match between Jeff Hardy and my boy Randy Orton. Well, both of these guys are my boys, honestly, but Jeff Hardy and Randy Orton going head-to-head in a Hell in a Cell match. And for some reason, I just don't see why this calls for a Hell in a Cell. I mean, these guys have had a brutal feud. You know, they've been beating the crap out of each other on SmackDown Live, but I don't feel like it's personal enough. I feel like, you know, Samoa Joe and AJ Styles would fit way better inside Hell in a Cell, given the storyline and the path and their careers, where they've gone and where they've been. But this matchup, I mean, whatever. I think it'll be a great matchup because, you know, we've seen these guys tear each other apart, and the Hell in a Cell hasn't even been a factor. You know, we've seen Swanton bombs through tables off of, you know, parts of the freaking crowd and the arena. We've seen Jeff Hardy get his ears ripped in half by Randy Orton. We've seen him get both beat down. So, I mean, this is going to be a very entertaining match. I hope to see a great one. I'm going to go with Randy Orton picking up the victory over Jeff Hardy right here, and probably riding Jeff Hardy off TV for a little bit, you know, heal up from some injuries and stuff like that. So I'm going Randy Orton to defeat Jeff Hardy in a Hell in a Cell. Next up, we have the SmackDown Live Tag Team Championship match between The New Day and either The Bar or Rusev Day. At the time I'm recording this, the number one contendership has not yet been decided on SmackDown Live. So this Tuesday night, two or three days from now, we will see The Bar and Rusev Day go head-to-head. For all I know, it could end up being a triple threat match for the SmackDown Live Tag titles, but whoever it is, whether it be Rusev Day or The Bar, I'm going with The New Day to retain, guys. They're just on super hot fire right now. I mean, they're on top of the world. They're the best tag team in the world right now. They just want them back from the Bludgeon Brothers, and I think that they're going to stay on top right here. I'm going with The New Day to retain. I just think it's the best option. If I were WWE, I would put all three of these teams in like a TLC or some sort of crazy stipulation matchup and have them tear the house down at Hell in a Cell. That's what I would do, or lock them all three in a Hell in a Cell. Just screw it. Just have some crazy match with all three teams and, I don't know, have some fun with it. But I'm going with The New Day to retain. Next up, we have the SmackDown Live Women's Championship match between Charlotte Flair and Becky Lynch. This should easily be the best women's match of the night here, as Charlotte will defend her title against Becky Lynch. I love Becky Lynch to death. My favorite woman on the entire WWE roster. I just think that it is her time, man. She worked so hard to build up her resume, you know, worked hard to get that WWE Women's Championship, and then Charlotte comes out of nowhere from injury and just gets her opportunity against Carmella, gets that championship, steals it right from under Becky's nose. I think we could really... There's a few ways this could go, you know, with Evolution coming soon, that all-women's pay-per-view in October. I really do not know where they're going to go with this. I mean, I guess they could put the title on Becky right now and, you know, have this continue. I'm going to go with Charlotte to retain here. I'm going Charlotte to retain, even though I really want Becky to win. I'm going to go with Charlotte to retain, and I don't think this will be the end. I think we'll have a rematch probably at Evolution between the two or something like that. But Charlotte to retain the SmackDown Live Women's Championship. Next up, we have the Raw Women's Championship match between Ronda Rousey and Alexa Bliss. And this one's pretty easy, guys. I mean, Ronda Rousey has to retain here. Alexa Bliss clearly made it known that she could not even lay a finger on Ronda Rousey. So I'm going with Ronda Rousey with ease here. I think Ronda Rousey retains the Raw Women's Championship and Alexa Bliss moves on for something else. And we're going to get a more equipped opponent for Ronda Rousey moving forward. I would like to see Sasha Banks or Bayley in this position. I think that would be really entertaining. Maybe a heel Sasha Banks. But yes, this matchup's pretty simple. I'm going with Ronda Rousey to retain. Next up, we have the WWE Championship match between AJ Styles and Samoan Joseph. And someone please tell me why this isn't a Hell in a Cell match. I don't see how this isn't. At the time I'm recording this, this is not a Hell in a Cell match. It could have changed by now, and if it is a Hell in a Cell match, thank God. But if it's not, then there's no reason that this should be taking place, guys. I don't see why this is not, or at least a stipulation of some sort. You know, no DQ. These guys have been going at it. This feud is personal. This feud has longevity. This feud has been going at each other's throats and back and forth and just all kinds of crazy stuff. There's no reason this shouldn't be in a Hell in a Cell match, but I'm going to go with AJ Styles to retain here. I think that Samoan Joseph has had a great run here as a heel in SmackDown Live, and that I just don't see him taking the championship off AJ. AJ's on top of the world. I think that he is the best for business right now. 2K19's about to come out, and I think they really want to push that as him as the cover athlete, as the champion. So I'm going with AJ Styles to retain here, and this should definitely be a Hell in a Cell match if it's not already. And for our main event, guys, we have a Universal Championship Hell in a Cell match between Braun Strowman and Roman Reigns. Braun Strowman officially cashing in his Money in the Bank contract at Hell in a Cell here, and I highly anticipate the Shield getting involved in this matchup somehow. You know, Dean Ambrose, Seth Rollins, Drew McIntyre, Dolph Ziggler, the whole freaking roster is going to be involved in this matchup, and I don't really know what they're doing. I said earlier that I think that, you know, we'll end up having a Raw Tag Team Championship match between Drew McIntyre, Dolph Ziggler, and Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose. That might not happen, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be added to the card if it's not. But I could see, you know, Roman Reigns retaining here and having all the belts all around these men, standing in the middle of a Hell in a Cell over Braun Strowman and the rest, you know, doing their Shield pose, all gold in hand, Raw tag titles, Intercontinental title, Universal title, all wrapped around their waist, looking fresh. I could totally see that happening here. I'm going with Roman Reigns to retain, guys. I just don't see Braun Strowman winning this matchup. I highly doubt that's going to happen. They're not going to take the Universal title off their golden boy that quickly. So I'm going with Roman Reigns to retain, but I know the Shield's going to get involved. I expect to have a nice anticipated high-flying, I expect this to be a high-collision matchup, you know, hard-hitting, a bunch of high spots, nothing too technical at all between Braun Strowman and Roman Reigns. There should be nothing but weapons and cage and just... I think they could book a really good story out of this match, and I hope they do tell that story here, but Roman Reigns will walk out of Hell in a Cell as Universal Champion, and that pretty much does it for my Hell in a Cell 2018 predictions, guys. Again, I hate that I don't have the full card in front of me as of the time I'm recording this, but hey, hopefully I can either pin them down in the comments section below, or you already heard them, and I had, you know, special powers, and I knew what matches were going to be booked in the first place. But that's going to do it for this video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Comment down below your predictions for Hell in a Cell 2018. Leave a like. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.